And welcome into the ballpark. Happy to have you with us. The show brings you a matchup of division rivals. It's the New York Mets taking on the Miami Marlins. First pitch coming your way next. Just about to get underway and towing the slab, Sandy Alcantara.
So dominant in his last start, double-digit strikeouts. It's going to be interesting today to see if he's able to have command of his secondary pitches the way he did last time out.
So just about set now. Here's Mark Canna.
Leading off tonight for the Mets, the left fielder, Mark Canna.
The wind of the pitch. And first offering is fouled off.
First pitch, 640.
Righty to the plate. That one fouled off. And a pitch. And that's outside.
Two strikes.
And now it's 1-2. And a ball evens the count. The wind of the pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive. The 2-2 now. And a swing and a miss. Now one away.
Way out in front of that inside pitch there, and just exactly the opposite kind of approach that you want with two strikes. You want to let the ball travel. Make sure you recognize it. Try to shorten up so that you can at least put the ball in play. Clearly fooled, but I think even more so, you question the two-strike approach.
Here's Brandon Nimmo. In there for strike one. Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
No score, just getting started, top of the first. Stays alive. That one not close. It's a ball and two strikes. One down, base is empty.
Two balls, two strikes.
And that one ripped to left, and it stays fair. Around first, heading for two. And that's a two-bagger.
Gotta love the resiliency he showed in that at bat, battling with two strikes. Pretty much a model swing on that one as he ripped it into the opposite field gap. And I'm sure he's going to be watching that one back on video, because that's the kind of swing you want to bottle. So many positives that led to that knock.
Man, it's second with one away. Now it's J.D. Davis. And that's in there for strike one. The 0-1 is outside, and it's a ball and a strike.
Really good check swing right there. So difficult to hold off on the slider from a same side thrower. Very difficult to pick up the release point.
And the righty deals. Nope. And that one missing low. Pitches in for a strike. It's 2-2. And fouled off. Runner at second here, one gone. Oh. Ripped to first, caught. Here's a Mets lineup now. And a big factor for them in recent games, Eduardo Escobar.
And Boog, he's a guy who loves coming up with the chance to drive in his teammates. It's like he finds another level of focus, batting over 300 with runners in scoring position this season. And you know what? Because of that, I wonder if the guys in front of him will see some better pitches to hit, because you don't want to put any free base runners on with him looming in the on-deck circle.
First offering misses the mark. Here comes a pitch. Fought off, foul. Man at second. Good eye right there.
This hitter's looking for a fastball, but I'm not sure he's going to get one. Pitcher doesn't have to challenge him. If he feels better about his off-speed secondary stuff, then stay with it.
Runner leads away at second.
Out there on the mound, he's setting the tone early with the fastball. 98 miles per hour up on the scoreboard.
Two outs. And one in scoring position. And he swings and lifts one to deep center field. That's back there. Gone! Pete Alonso takes him deep. His 19th home run of the year. It's 2-0.
Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
So two down, and stepping in for New York, Eduardo Escobar. Good power, not great in the OBP department. Next offering is in for a strike. And a 1-1. That's down and in.
They've got him working a little harder in this first frame than he anticipated.
Next pitch misses. And that's ball three. Swing and a miss. 3-2 now. Swing and a foul ball at the plate. They'll do it again. Tough start for him so far, already at 30 pitches here in the first. The pitch. Just a slow ground ball this time. Fires over to first. Escobar out of the play. Out number three. Mets add two runs on this blast. And it's 2-0. Bottom of the first, on the hill and coming off a great start, Taiwan Walker. And Singy, we were talking earlier about how he's doing a great job navigating through tough spots.
I've just been so impressed with when it seems like there's more pressure, he's more calm and settles in. He's done an incredible job with runners in scoring position. Most guys, they get a little tight, they start to aim the baseball, but for some reason, he gets looser, the ball comes out of his hand with more life, and he's able to wiggle off the hook of, you know, tough.
As we take a look at Don Mattingly's lineup for the Marlins, and a guy having a big year for him, Ryan Anderson.
Boog, this is one of those guys you want at the plate in those big game-defining moments. I mean, he's such a consistent hitter. You got to love watching him in those situations, and hopefully we'll get a chance to see that in this one.
Jorge Soler up at the plate. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
The pitch.
2-0 count. Great hitter at the dish. If you're going to miss, you've got to miss outside the zone. You miss inside the strike zone, you'll be asking the umpire for a new baseball.
Next offering misses, and it's 3-0. Just a few pitches in, but not very sharp on the mound in the home half of the first.
But when you can score some runs for your pitcher in that first inning, you really want him to come out and shut that other team down so you guys can get back in the dugout and swing the bats. You've obviously got some hot sticks in the early part of this one.
The pitch. Fouls one away, and now 3-2. And the right-hander deals. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. Now two out. And now it's Garrett Cooper up to hit.
The first baseman, Garrett Cooper.
And first offering is fouled off. Why to kick the pitch. Squibbed out in front of the plate. Gets it to first. It. Inning over. And 1-2-3 go the Marlins. They trail it here 2-0. All set for the start of the inning. And stepping in for New York, Francisco Lindor. The pitch. That one missed.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
Righty delivers. Swing and a foul back. That's out of play. And here it comes. And it is 2-1. Kicks and fires. In for a strike. It's 2-2.
Man, 91 on the slider right there. That's a hard one. That's a low-end fastball for some guys.
Left-hand batter waits. Cut on and miss. Struck him out. One up, one down. Dom Smith stands in.
The center fielder, number 2, dominates.
First offering misses badly for ball one. And the 1-0.
2-0.
Larry Bullard making the calls behind the plate for us in this one. Pretty good strike zone. Well reviewed by those we talked to around the league.
Yeah, he's an umpire. He doesn't get a lot of looks from players. Maybe here and there once in a while, but he's appreciated back there. Started after the 2-0, now an appeal to third. And yes, he offered at it. That one fouled off, 2-2. Next offering way off the plate. The pitch. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. Payoff pitch. And it's ball four. He missed down low.
Well, that's a nice job of grinding out that at bat. Saw a lot of pitches and ends up drawing the walk. Very gritty.
Man at first with one gone. Jeff McNeil up now for the Mets. And that chance handled. Rojas for one. On to first, double play. And that's the inning. We go to the bottom of inning number two. It's the Mets 2 and the Marlins nothing. Back here at Lone Depot Park, we head to the bottom of the second. Now it's the DH, Jesus Aguilar. And a pitch. Misses outside, 1-0. Walker, not a big strikeout guy, but still very effective as far as starting pitchers go. One of those guys that involves the defense and really gets him involved in the action. Next offering is in for a strike.
He moves the ball around all the quadrants of the strike zone and will add and subtract velocity. And because of that, he gets the weak contact. It's all about missing the barrel of the bat.
And a pitch. And fires in a fastball at 95. It seems like this type of guy is kind of a dying breed nowadays.
Well, exactly. When teams are looking for high velocity, high strikeout rates, a guy like this doesn't necessarily do that. So in order to really appreciate how good he is, you have to see him, because if you're just looking at a stat sheet, you might overlook him.
And that's ball four. Abisail Garcia up to the plate. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. At the belt and fires. On the ground, a short, could be two. To second, there's one. Over to Alonso, double play.
Very smooth on the feed to second right there. You gotta love that glove toss, Boone. You know, sometimes people think these guys are being a little flashy, but it actually can make more sense to do that than try to make a full transfer. And you gotta remember, these guys work on that play all the time, so it's in their back pocket whenever they need it.
Now the third baseman, Ryan Anderson. First pitch, just misses.
This lineup's going to have to find a way to make him work a little harder out there on the mound. I mean, he is just mowing them down. He's settling in. You got to make him uncomfortable. Maybe step out of the box, call timeout, do whatever it takes.
Next offering is in for a strike.
That fastball at the bottom of the zone can be very effective. Just got to keep it on the corners.
Next offering is in the dirt. Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. He'll touch them all, and they inch closer. It's 2-1.
When a guy's got a real hard fastball, you can't overswing. All you've got to do is get the bat head to the spot. If you do, he supplies the power, and you'll get to jog around the bases like he did right there.
Two outs, nobody on. Jesus Sanchez, the next up for the Marlins. And first offering is fouled off. Two outs. Pitch misses there. And the count even 1-1. And he deals. And it's fouled away.
See how the catcher wanted that pitch up and in. Wanted to try to tie him up. That's the one thing we're seeing, that high fastball. You have to get it up there because of how hitters have changed their swings.
That one down the line, and it goes just foul. The 1-2. Swing and a tapper that rolls foul. Kicks and deals. Look out! And it hit him. He had him 1-2, and he ends up hitting him with a pitch. Two outs, runner at first. Miguel Rojas at the plate. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Sanchez, the runner at first with two gone. Next one is off the plate. Ball two. And there's a ball.
Well, I would expect in this 3-0 count, you're taking all the way. See if they'll walk you.
Three oh down. The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
Not what he wanted to do there, Boog. That keeps this inning alive and gives this offense a good chance to cut into their deficit.
First and second, two outs. And here's the rookie catcher, Joe Mack.
And, Boog, I'd say he's due.
First offering misses the mark. And a pitch on the ground right side, and it's just foul. That was close. Righty to the plate, swings and he pops it up near the pitcher's mound, brings it in. That is the inning. Marlins get a bit closer on this homer, and the home team down a run. Welcome back. Top half of the third inning. Here's the catcher for the Mets, Tomas Nido. Yeah, the right-hander back to work. There's the strike.
I mean, that's perfect location, right on the black. I mean, over and over again, this guy demonstrates the ability to hit those spots. They're so tough to do anything with as a hitter.
The wind and the pitch. Swing and a miss. Now 1-2. Swing and a slow roller. To first, but it pulls him off the bag. Back to the top of the Mets order. Here's the Mets leadoff man, Mark Canna. He's sitting on 99 career homers. We'll see if this is the moment to notch number 100. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
The only adjustment he needs to make is his target. If you aim at the outside corner, that slider's going to end up way off the plate. Perhaps look a little more down the middle, and you get it right where you want it.
That's a hit. Throws to second. Not in time. He's safe.
Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
And stepping in is the speedy Brandon Nimmo.
Really good piece of hitting last time going to the opposite field.
First pitch, and he just misses. Next offering is down low, and now 2-0. Here comes a pitch in the air, left side, and that is a big first out. Now it's J.D. Davis. Comes into this one with the seventh best batting average in the NL. First offering, and it just misses. Runners at first and second with one gone. Next offering is in for a strike. And the righty deals. That misses the zone. Now two balls and a strike. And a seed into center. That's a base hit. And they hold the runner at third, but the bases are loaded now with one out.
Showed some really nice patience in that at bat. Worked himself into a good count. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee. Now the bases loaded. Big opportunity for them to break this game open.
Here's Pete Alonso. Right-hander kicks, deals.
Oh, up there.
Nito on third. Canna on second. Davis over at first with one away. The pitch. That misses the zone. 2-2. All loaded up. Dangerous hitter at the plate. Good eye right there. Three balls, two strikes the count. That is ball four, and that'll bring home a run.
He's really gotten himself into a mess out there and now forces home a run with the walk. This inning's definitely getting away from him.
So the bases are loaded here. One man gone. Eduardo Escobar up now for the Mets. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Bullpen activity starting up now. James Hoyt getting loose out there. Loaisiga, a hard-throwing right-hander, up as well. Righty delivers. Gets him to chase after that one.
Knowing that the pitcher wants a ground ball double play opportunity here, you've got to lay off pitches down in the zone. Right there, swinging at that pitch, that's a no-no.
Swings and misses, and the count is 1-2. Pitch. Swing and a ball lifted in the air, left field, pretty well struck. Drops in for a hit, couldn't run it down. One run across, Rojas with a relay home. Not in time, he's safe at the plate. And they lead by four.
Gets the job done as he brings home a pair. This was a really nice swing. Didn't quite get enough behind it to get it out of here, but once it got over his head in left field, it was extra bases all the way.
Here's Francisco Lindor. In there, and it's 0-1. One down, runners at second and third. Next offering is in for a strike.
Quickly into an 0-2 count. Both pitches were down in the zone. I think you set your sights a little bit higher because you'll have a tendency to chase if you look down in that area.
The 1-2. Little chopper rolls foul. And a ball and two strikes. Got him. And he's down on strikes for the second time today. And now the center fielder, Dominic Smith. He reached on a walk his first time. So RBI spot, but Chris, this is a guy that is not really swinging the bat all that well here.
In this situation, you have a real good opportunity to get swings and misses and record a strikeout. I think you attack him in this spot.
And makes the grab. And that is that. We head down to the home half of inning number three. It's the Mets 5 and the Marlins 1. Set for the bottom of the third, here's Joey Wendell. The Marlins in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. I need a good at bat out of him right here.
There's a strike.
And I know you want to be patient as a hitter, but you got to be ready to jump on the first thing straight. And he got one right there, but left the bat on his shoulder.
The wind of the pitch.
0-2 is the count.
A foul ball. Way outside. He steps back. Leap back to here. Third. And for money. For his own. If only the shit'll be right. Well, the outside. Oh, 7 on 5th. Next for the Marlins. Today's first time. Pitch is down. That is a wall. Two down to all gun. And the game's there.
Been right out. Damn that fastball. Real tough hit.
Down the way, and it's out three. Mars down here, five. Back money, on Chubby Wist, and set the lead over. Jeff. Left hitter. So
miss not with Jeff velocity.
The rider deals. Oh, hold the ball. 2-1. The ball. Oh, 3-1. That one missed, so you don't walk.
You think you draw big, we give you a bat.
I think the eight pitcher almost got it. Yeah, I think you draw. Yeah, in fact, John, that's a pitch. Just missed. Working on his own, starting to get bad for that ground ball.
Back stickers, he's in for some weight contact. Get the hitter to roll over. Now hit it. Have to really look. You'll let chain the ball. You're so high. You get stay.
Hit on round. When this game? I'm covered in double. He's playing on the more perfectly with it there.
He was determined to get better take at that swing. Got to go deep. It's really behind him. Take all of it. A jab.
The pitch. For it. I am not always. And here stays alive. In the air, move this one. Catch it over. And come out of the gate. Do that car. That's the next stop.
Same thing with all those kind of hitters take the camp door. Hold off, he really sits in there now.
The one. The Gretel, and that's just foul. That one ripped and aboard a leadoff sink.
Everything came together perfectly right there. He recognized the position of the baseball out of hand, say, all backside, cross pit. There were any fields where I wake up here with the condition to move with that.
So, man, four, half the bottomless, I think Garcia, a front so far, all that will drill back. That's it. Over the first two leads, that one, that's it. That's it. This is more. And the one to third. And foul ball. That's one. I glove around third. Court 5-2.
Got down the line. There. We hit the ball out of line. It's too deep. Tight to your body. So around that baseball and put it in foul territory. And that right there was perfect.
Jesus Sanchez, the next up for the Marlins.
Up next for the Marlins. The center fielder.
First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Well, he's just given up three straight hits, and now behind in this count to this hitter. Might be a good time for somebody to call a timeout. Maybe the pitching coach go out there and talk to him just a little bit.
And a pitch. Bounce to the right. Oh, look at the stop. Off balance feed. There's one. And that's two.
That was a much-needed double play right there. It gives him a really good shot at minimizing any further damage in this inning.
Miguel Rojas getting ready to hit. Worked a walk in his first trip to the plate. Singh, you talk about a guy that has all the skills. The range is really good, but the arm just stands out, and he makes all the plays. And a foul ball. Runner at third, two away.
Yeah.
And because of that big power arm, he's able to play a little bit deeper, make throws from the outfield grass all the way across the diamond, and still get a pretty good runner. That's impressive.
Next pitch is downstairs. Kicks and fires. Foul ball there. Next offering upstairs. In the air, right side. Snags it on the run. And that's the inning. So one run in the inning on this base hit. It's 5-2. We're back, and there's a new arm on the mound to start the fifth. James Hoyt. It's his job to keep his team in the game.
Well, at this point of the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Back here at the ballpark, we go to the top of the fifth, and stepping in for New York, Brandon Nimmo. And he deals. And that's in for a strike. Yoan. Good eye in that spot. That misses the zone. 2-1.
2-1.
And that's downed away.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with a 3-1 count.
Next offering finds the zone, and the count is full. Kicks and deals. Got him looking. And the leadoff man set down in their half of the fifth.
Wow, that's a tough call for the hitter, but the pitcher will take that all day long. Not quite in the strike zone, but he found a spot that the umpire is going to, at least for now, allow him to get that call. So hitters are going to have to make an adjustment, but pitchers are going to learn from those things and really try to exploit them if they can.
And there's a foul ball. Here comes a pitch.
Nope. One ball, one strike.
And a count 1-2. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him.
Very strong coming out of the pen so far as he punches out the first two batters he's faced in this one, getting straight to work. Man, it's talked about a lot, but relievers are just so electric these days. These aren't fun at bats if you're a hitter. I'm so glad I'm retired.
Two outs, base is empty. And now it's the polar bear, Pete Alonso. He's already homered here in this one. In there for strike one. Next offering is in for a strike.
0-2.
Two outs. Swing and a miss, and he got him. And the Mets go 1-2-3.
Impeccable command in that one. Three batters, three strikeouts. That's electric stuff out there on the mound. Got your own, you ain't got to run a stand. Give me a chance. I got my bands up. 20s, 50s, 100s in my hand. VIP, I'm cooling like a fan.
I ain't here for problems, not a... We head to the bottom of the fifth, and now the catcher comes up to hit. Joe Mack.
For the Marlins, the catcher.
And a pitch. And a good fastball to start him off. That's strike one. And a pitch. And a swing and a miss.
Wow. Good luck catching up to that one.
The wind of the pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Here's the 0-2. In the air, left field, down the line, and a base hit. And that turns the lineup over.
Good two-strike hitting right there, Boog. A bit of a lost start for some, so that was nicely done to beat the odds. Just a bloop hit behind third right there, and that's a really tough play for a third baseman or shortstop to get to, and the same for the left fielder. So he just found a perfect place to drop that one in right there.
And now, Joey Wendell. Nope. And the first pitch misses for ball one. On a line, base hit. Throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
Everything was on time and fluid in that swing. Got a pitch he could get the barrel on and lined it into center for the knock. Those always feel good.
So up next, Jorge Soler. And first offering is fouled off. Right-hander kicks, deals. Rolled over to third. Dive, and he's got it. The throw over to McNeil. On to first, save. So they get one, but a really nice try there.
Well, they had the chance of turning two right there, but I don't think he got a good grip on the ball as he tried to transfer from glove to throwing hand. They say you can't assume a double play. I beg to differ at the big league level, but it's going to be ruled as a fielder's choice. Excuse me, miss, like, what's your name? How about we just
tone it down? Then go back to where you came from. So digging in, Garrett Cooper. And first offering is fouled off. Tying run at the plate.
I got one ball, one strike.
First and third, one down. Swing and a miss. One and two.
Big time jam right there. I hate it as a hitter, but standing in center field, you can't help but chuckle a little bit.
The 1-2. And the 1-2 misses to even the count. Righty to the plate. That's inside. Counts full, 3-2. The pitch in the air, center field. Smith drifts towards it. Drops into the glove. Runner tagging from third. Throw, and it gets away. He's in to score on the sack fly. It's 5-3.
Sometimes all you got to do is your job, and don't overcomplicate things. Keep it simple. Runner third, less than two outs. Put the ball in play, and a nice job with the sack fly.
And now it's Jesus Aguilar. And a foul ball. That hits the dirt, and now it's even 1-1. Soler off of first with two away. Next one misses, and it's 2-1. This one in the air, right field. He's got it, and that is out number three. So they pick up a run on two hits, no errors, and a man left. We're through five. It's the Mets 5 and the Marlins 3. Back here at Lone Depot Park, Eduardo Escobar, El Caballo up to hit.
Well, both sides equally as strong, so not a good time to try to turn him around with a relief pitcher and put him up.
Oh, this one high and deep, way back there. And that one is out of here. Eduardo Escobar leaves the park, his 17th of the year. And they add a run. It's 6-3.
Anytime you have a pitch down the middle of the plate, the percentages go up for the hitter to do damage, even if it's a pretty good sinker like that one. Nice piece of hitting there at the plate.
And now it's Frankie Lindor. And first offering is fouled off.
Well, you just got to delete it. You give up that leadoff home run, go back to work, focus on this next batter.
Righty delivers. Strike two. Double-barreled action in the bullpen. Zach Pop, the right-handed sinker baller. He looks to be readying himself. Loaisiga warming up as well. The pitch. Misses. And that's ball one.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Chop to the right side. Over to Cooper. Lindor retired.
The center fielder, number two, Dominic Smith.
Now it's Dominic Smith. First pitch, not close. The 1-0. Good eye right there.
Two balls, no strike.
Misses with the 2-0, and he's fired three straight outside the strike zone. Right-handed reliever. Outside corner, there's a strike. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk. One down. And now here's Jeff McNeil. First offering misses the mark.
good slider down and in can be so hard to get on plane with. You're better off taking that pitch.
Next one off the plate inside. Two balls, no strikes. Puts it in the air out towards left center. Drops for a hit. He couldn't run it down. Smith around third. Rojas with a relay throw in there. He scores. It's 7-3.
Well, they call that an advantage count for a reason. You're so much more likely to get something you can handle.
I love the approach he had right there with that pitch. Not trying to do too much, but still looking to drive it. And that's exactly what he's able to do into the opposite field gap for the double.
Tomas Nito at the plate. To the right side. And they got him.
Up next for the Mets, the left fielder, Mark Canna.
So the batting order turns over. Now the left fielder, Mark Canna.
Possibly thinking about home run number 100 here. He's just one shy of that milestone.
That one's in there, 0-1.
0-1 is the count.
You'll one. That one hit to right. Garcia under it. And that's the third out. We go to the bottom half of inning number six. And the 5-6-7 slots do up. It's the Mets 7 and the Marlins 3. Yeah, you know it's me. You can't stop my shot. Bottom of the six. And at the plate for Miami, Abisail Garcia. He's someone that you might not describe as having elite level speed, but he can absolutely move, and it is a factor in his game. That one catches the zone, and that's strike one.
Boog, this guy's definitely a plus runner, but what I love about him is that he goes all out every single time, never takes a break. It's guys like that, even though they don't have the elite speed, the fact that they're consistent with it, they make moves on the base paths.
Next pitch inside, 1-1. And the righty deals. Now a screamer into the outfield. Nimmo makes the play, and there's one down.
Not fooled at all right there. He was clearly all over it, but sometimes you hit it too hard and right at someone. You're looking for one of those bloop hits to get a knock sometimes.
Anderson batting with one down takes a strike. The pitch. Ball one low. The why to kick the pitch. Way out front for strike two.
Clearly he was sitting on a fastball right there and just ended up out in front of the slider. Hey, you can't fault him for his commitment. Now he's just gonna have to battle two strikes.
Here's the 2-2. Swings through that and it's a strikeout. Two gone.
Thought it was a pretty good pitch. Top of the strike zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Hitters, especially with two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger.
Two outs, bases empty. And up next for Miami, Jesus Sanchez. Next pitch is popped up. Escobar gets under it. And that will end the inning. Miami down in order. Deficit remains at 4. It's 7-3. Welcome back. We're in the 7th. We have a new pitcher on the mound, Zach Pop. And this guy can bring it velocity-wise. Welcome back. We go to the top of the 7th. Digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Brandon Nimmo. And here it comes. And that one fouled off. The 0-1.
1-1.
And that's outside. Two down. The punch out there, and they get the leadoff hitter in the 7th. And next is the designated hitter, J.D. Davis, for the 4th time tonight. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Bounced up the middle. On to first. And two away to start the 7th.
Well, a well-thrown slider like that one can be tough to get in the air. Good downward break on that one.
And now, Pete Alonso. And it was a homer back in the first inning that got his day started at the plate.
Yeah, Boog, a two-run blast as fans were just still getting into their seats here at the ballpark. So if you showed up late to this one, you missed out on a big moment early on.
And the first offering is not close. Two down, nobody on. Just missed.
2-0.
Swing and a ball hammered left field on its way and gone. He sends a rocket to left. Home run number 20 on the year. It's 8-3.
Well, he had the green light there in the 3-0 count, and sometimes guys can be a little too anxious, but he was very patient, allowed the pitch to get into the zone, and once it did, he jumped all over it. Really good piece of hitting.
So two away with nobody on. So up next for New York, Eduardo Escobar. The third baseman, Eduardo Escobar. And first offering is fouled off. And the right-hander deals.
And ball one. One and one.
That one is absolutely belted. And it slams off the bottom of the wall. In safely with a double, his second of the day.
Nice double right there. Loud contact coming off the bat. Didn't get enough air under to drive it out of here, but you'll take that swing and that result every time.
Man at second here with two away. Now up to hit Francisco Lindor. And that's in there for strike one.
0-1.
The pitch. Next offering misses down and away. Runner at second, two down. The next pitch misses, and a count 2-1.
He's getting a little frustrated out there on the mound, getting hit around a little bit. Let's see if he can settle himself down.
The 2-1. And that's outside. Swing and a miss, and it's a full count now. Three, two on the way. So now two on and two outs.
You get a walk, and you get a walk. Everyone gets a walk, boo.
So first and second with two outs. And next for the Mets, Dominic Smith. And that one wrapped foul. Escobar over at second. Lindor at first, two out of the inning. Next pitch is in the dirt. And 1-1. Kicks and fires. And that one off the outside edge.
It's a big opportunity right here, but I love the way he's slowing the game down. He's shrinking his zone, making sure he gets the pitch that he wants to hit.
Left-hand hitter waits. In the air on the infield, Anderson under this one. And the inning is over. A Pete Alonso blast for the Mets. It's now 8-3. Many years ago, we saw this possibility. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the seventh. Carlos Carrasco. And a healthy-sized lead for him to go to work with.
They know that he can get a right-hander out, but he's in position to face a couple of lefties this inning.
Set for the last half of the seventh. Here's the shortstop at the plate, Miguel Rojas. And he deals. And a strike in there. At the belt and fires. And there's a ball. And a pitch.
Ball, that's inside.
He swings and fouls one off. The next offering misses. 3-2 now. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. And a payoff pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And one gone.
Oh, nothing too fancy on the strikeout pitch right there. Just a low 90s fastball, and I'm not sure he was trying to challenge him, but that's pretty much what happened. Very hittable location, but he found a way to just get it by him.
And the batter now, Joe Mack, 1-2. And that one pulled foul. Here comes a pitch. Left field, Canna ranging into the alley. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's two away. And now it's going to be Joey Wendell. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Two outs. To the right side. Alonso takes it to the bag. Inning over. Starting to run out of outs as they're unable to chip away. Eighth inning coming up. It's the Mets 8 and the Marlins 3. New pitcher on here, Anthony Bass. He comes in with his team trailing by a bunch, so he'll try to keep it where it is. New inning getting started, and stepping in for New York, Jeff McNeil. The pitch just missed. Two balls, no strikes, the count. And a pitch. Swing and a miss. And it's 2-1. Next offering is downstairs. Lined, and that's a base hit.
Well, when you fall behind in the count, you've got to come into the zone, and then guys have a better chance of hitting the ball hard like he did right there.
Man at first, Tomas Nido will hit next. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. And he'll one. Swing and a miss.
Two pretty nasty sliders to get this hitter in an 0-2 count. If you're up there at the plate, you got to look up in the zone and spit on anything that's down.
Rojas over to Wendell. There's one, and they get him easily at first. It's a double play. Here's the left fielder, Mark Canna. In there, and it's 0-1. Now the 0-1. Not the best swing that time from the first round pick. Righty to the plate. That's down and in.
Well, he missed badly with that 0-2 fastball. Hitter has to understand, probably wants to try to put him away with that pitch, so got to stay ready for it.
Right-hander kicks, deals.
Straighten him up a little bit.
Righty delivers. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. That's out number three. Back here in Miami, bottom of the eighth. And now for the Marlins, Jorge Soler. The pitch. Swings through that one for strike one. Pitch misses, and that's ball one. Right-handed reliever. Swing and a miss as he was out front that time. And a pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out, and that's the first out. Garrett Cooper, the next up for the Marlins. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Here's the 0-1. Swing and a miss as he was late.
Another 0-2 count right here. Pitcher just in the driver's seat. He can go anywhere he wants to go right here.
0-2 now. Stays alive. And the next pitch is way outside. Swings and misses. Back-to-back strikeouts.
Oh, that slider wasn't even close to the strike zone, and he got him to chase. That's just a bad approach right there. Either he was looking for something else and got completely fooled, or he was sitting all over the slider and just couldn't resist the temptation. But, man, really expanded right there and didn't have a chance to make the contact with that pitch.
Jesus Aguilar, the next up for the Marlins. High fly ball, right field. Makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. Nothing doing for the Marlins. Can't chip away at an 8-3 deficit. So the Marlins go with a new arm, Dylan Floro. And we'll see how he performs in this situation with his team down big. And stepping in for New York, Brandon Nimmo. The wind of the pitch. And that's outside. And a 1-0. Line drive, base hit.
Right there, he does a great job of staying in the big part of the field. Man, there are a lot of hits there.
J.D. Davis up now for the Mets. in there for strike one. Nimmo on at first, nobody out. Next offering is down low. Is upstairs, and it's 2-1. On the out ball, it's a double play.
The back, the first baseman, Pete Alonso.
Stepping in, the long ball threat, Pete Alonso. And everyone is thinking the same thing right now.
Yeah, they're thinking, will he do it again? He's already homered twice, and most recently in the seventh. This guy's left a huge mark on this game.
As well as on the baseball. And who can move like this? Check swing, but he went too far. And it's 0-1. The wind and the pitch. Strike two.
Well, I've noticed they've been pitching him hard inside, and the key is if you're going to make a mistake, you got to make it off the dish. If it leaks out over the plate with this kind of power, you'll be asking for a new baseball.
The 0-2. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Got him. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. 5, 6, and 7 will lead things off in the bottom of the ninth. It's the Mets 8 and the Marlins 3. Back here at the ballpark, all set for the bottom of the ninth. And now the right fielder, Avisail Garcia. Carrasco back to work. That one at the knees for a strike. Carrasco, he's known at least in part for his changeup, and it's not just about changing speeds. He gets some serious movement. And the 0-2. And now 1-2.
And that movement is, I mean, really what makes the difference, because a hitter can know that the changeup is coming and try to time up his rhythm to connect. But when it has that late movement, you miss the bat, or maybe you get it off the end.
And down on strikes he goes. One away.
Really love the pitch sequence right there. I'm telling you what, pitcher and catcher are on the same page right now.
Ryan Anderson now at the plate. He's already homered in this game. First offering misses the mark. Next offering misses, and it's 2-0. The 2-0 is in for a strike.
In today's game, not that many fastball counts, but hitters still in the back of their minds, they're looking for one. 2-0 changeup call right there. Excellent pitch selection to go with.
Puts it away for the out. Two outs, base is empty. Jesus Sanchez, the next up for the Marlins. That one's in there, 0-1. Next offering down low and in the dirt. Swing and a miss. And a count 1-2. Down to their final strike. Right through there. Got him. And that'll do it.
Well, I'm not sure if he expected to get 9 outs in this one, but he had the gas in the tank to get it done. Kind of a throwback save for this guy today, but helps the team get the win. As you can see, they're pretty happy about it, and they're celebrating his performance in this one.
8-3 the final in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew here at MLB The Show, thanks for stopping by. John Chambi. Talk to you soon. Can of my 5-pile. You not a threat, nothing to fight about. I see through you even when my light is out. Okay, hey, okay. You loud as a mouse, outside of my house. Not making no noise, just chasing the clout. Yeah, you want the cheese, but without no dreams. You will continue to sleep on the couch. Shooting the scene and making a scene. There's two different things that we're not about. Hey, okay, hey, okay, yeah. I feel like I got a lot to prove. I feel like y'all cannot walk in my shoes. I feel like I'm damaged beyond repair. I feel like I lost a whole lot of screws. I feel like as a kid, nobody was there for me mentally. Nothing else mattered.